Okay, so we are going to use Parallax method to devise a strategy to find the distances of heavenly objects like moon or some stars from the earth. Okay, now what happens is that suppose there is, let us say, there is a star like this. Okay, and I want to use parallax method. I want to find out the distance of this star from the earth. Okay, now even though we have drawn earth bigger than the star, but in reality earth is like a grain of sand in front of the size of the star. Okay, so you know, even if you go from this place to that place, the star will remain right above you. Its location will not shift. Okay, in the diagram it is very easy to draw, you know, you can draw it like this and then you know the distance between these two points, so you'll have this angle and all that. But in practical, this angle is zero, perfect zero. Okay, so there is a different strategy to find the distance of a very very far away star. Okay, but suppose star is close by, suppose the star is slightly closer, okay, then this angle could be, you know, close to zero, but you can still measure it, probably 0.001 degrees or radians like that. So you can measure it. Okay, how to measure that angle? To measure it, that angle, you look at the very very far away star which will be right above your head, because that's for that star the entire earth is like a point only. So star will be right ahead of you, right above you. So you look at the far away star, okay, which is this line of sight, and then you look at the nearby star, you get this angle. How much you have to rotate like this will give you this angle. Okay, then you go at far away place, then again you look at the same very far star which will be again right above you, and then you look at the nearby star, you get that angle. Suppose this is theta 1, this is theta 2, this angle will be equal to theta 1 plus theta 2. Understood? And once you know theta 1 plus theta 2, this should be equal to what? This length divided by that length. Okay? You exactly know that how far you have moved.
Yeah. Yeah.
So you, if you know the angle, you will get to know how far the star is from the earth. Okay? So we will be solving numericals related to this. Okay? So just that I thought I could introduce what kind of numericals will be there. Okay? And also one more thing is that we are dealing with extremely small angles. Okay? So we need to introduce a smaller unit of angle. It will not be comfortable to say that angle is, let's say, you know, 2.3 into 10 is power minus 4 degrees or minus 4 radians. So if I introduce a smaller unit, for example, if you have to talk about let's say distance of hydrogen's electron from the nucleus, you'll be talking in terms of angstrom. Right? Suppose you have to talk about distance of very very less, you'll be talking in terms of millimeters. Okay, so like that, if I have to talk about very very small angles, so I need to introduce a smaller, you know, a smaller unit of the angle itself. Okay, make sense? Okay, so let's try to introduce the smaller units of angle. Okay, so we already know what is 1 radians. Okay, there is something called 1 minute, which is 1 dash. Okay, 1 minute is 1 by 60th of radians. Write it down. And 1 second, 1 minute by 60.
1 by 3,000
radians, which happens to be equal to 1 divided by 3,600 radians. This is minutes. Minutes is for time, I understand that, okay? But for the angle also we are introducing minutes only, because we are dividing the radians into 60 equal parts. Just a convention. There is no as such this thing. Okay, now can you tell me how many radians 1 degree has? 1 degree has, can you write 1 degree in terms of radians? How much it is? Okay, try writing this. 1 degree, how many radians?
Pi by 180.
Yeah.
Calculate it. And then you have to tell me, you have to calculate and remember also. 1 minute, how many radians? 1 second, how many radians? The another name to minute is arc minute. Another name to second.
0.01.
Second is arc second.
0.0017.
How to get 1 degree? How many radians?
It's 0.017.
Pi radians is how many degrees?
180 degrees.
Okay. So basically, you can write like this, 180 degrees correspond to pi radians, so 1 degree will correspond to
pi by
180. Pi by 180. Okay, how much is pi by 180?
0.0174.
Okay, I'll write it down. This is 1.745 into 10 is power minus 2 radians. Okay, how much is 1 minute equal to?
In radians, right?
Yeah.
1 by 60.
How much it is?
It's 2.9 into 10 power minus 4.
2.9 into 10 power minus 4. You're using calculator? Calculate it quickly.
1.66 divided by 0.166.
Tell me the answer, final one.
0.166 bar. So 1.6.
That's wrong.
It
was,
it's 1.6.
Yeah,
and then you divide by
1 minute, no? 1 minute is 2.9.
Is it in terms of degrees?
No, he said in terms of radians. This is illegal. How can 1.60
so
be equal to this?
So how?
I think it's in
terms of degrees.
Yeah,
it's in terms
of
degrees. We have to multiply pi by 180 to
160. No. Wait. 1 minute. 1 minute is 1 degree divided by 60 radians.
Okay.
And like that. Whatever is 1 degree in terms of radians, you have to write that and then divide by 60.
Why does it have two units?
That makes more sense, yeah.
No, it's
5
by
3
basically.
That's
correct.
So, correction guys, 1 minute is 1 degree divided by 60. Okay, 1 degree you are splitting into 60 parts.
But then it's not radians.
Yeah.
It can't be 2 units.
You have to convert 1 degree in terms of radians, okay, and that you write in terms of radians. So you can say that this is 1.745 10 is for minus 2 divided by 60. This is what it is. This is the amount of radians. Okay, so this will be coming out to be that 1 degree we have divided into 60 parts. Alright? Now, can you find 1 second, how much?
Divide that by 60.
Divide that by 60 now. How much?
4.85 into 10 raised to minus 5.
Yeah.
10 is so minus 6.
5.
Minus 6.
Yeah.
Minus 6.
Right? Yeah.
Okay, so these 3 things, if you remember, it will be good. Okay, you can use it directly. Otherwise, you can anyways calculate. Okay?
degree. 1 minute is just 1/16 degree.
Yeah.
When you convert that to degrees.
1 minute, see, forget about the units. If you split 1 degree into 60 parts, one part is 1 minute. Okay? Now, that one part you can write in terms of degrees or in terms of radians. So if you have to convert it in terms of radians, you need to first write how much is 1 degree in terms of radians and then divide by 60. Alright, so that is what we have. Alright, and when you deal with the distances, always use SI units, radians. Okay, don't use degrees. Alright, any doubt, please ask. Any doubt? So, see, let me... you have this as 1 degree, okay, all of you focus here. This is suppose 1 degree, there is 1 degree angle. Degree is close to us because we have been using degrees since our childhood, but then, you know, radians is the SI unit, so we need to get familiar with the radians also, okay. This is 1 degree, till now we never used or we never have to use anything less than 1 degree. Okay, but now going forward, the angles we are dealing with are very, very small. So we are introducing a smaller unit than 1 degree. So what we have done is that we have split 1 degree angle into 60 equal parts. Okay, so how much will be the one part? 1 degree divided by 60. Okay, so that is the one. Stop talking. That is the 1 minute, okay? Now that I can write in terms of radians. How can I write in terms of radians? Convert 1 degree in radians. Convert 1 degree in the radians and then divide by 60, you'll get it in radians. Understood? All right? Similarly, 1 second is 1 minute divided by 60. You have not only split 1 degree into 60 part, each part of that you have again divided into 60. So we're dealing with extremely small angle when I say 1 second. Okay, so 1 second is 1 degree divided by 360. In terms of degrees, it is 1 divided by 360. That is in terms of degrees. But if you want to write that in terms of radians, you have to first write what is 1 degree in terms of radians and divide it by 360, 3600. This is 1 divided by 3600 degrees. Okay, this is in terms of degrees. If I have to convert this in radians, I need to write what is 1 degree in terms of radians and then divide by 3600. Okay, so we have introduced very, very small unit, and at times even this small unit is not sufficient to define the kind of the angles we are dealing with. Okay, any doubts now? Anything? So, let us move further. You know, these kind of things you will learn better when you solve numericals. Okay?